somewhat serious stuff and important stuff. You spent time in prison.
Yeah.
And but for the grace of God, you might have died in prison.
Yeah.
And now a documentary about what is called A Survivor's Guide to Prison.
Right.
Talk to me about this.
Well, you're more apt to go to prison in the United States than any other country in the world, including China. And when you think about that, that's amazing. We're the land of the free, you know, but we have 5,000 jails in the United States. That's more jails than universities and colleges, you know, so it's like backwards, you know, and the documentary is about like three people that actually were wrongly convicted, and there's like 40,000 to possibly 100,000 people that are in prison right now wrongly convicted. The biggest problem right now that we have is that the district attorney who is against you has all the power. Judges no longer have power. Mm-hmm. There's a certain thing going that the district attorney will say, look, you either get 10 years or plead guilty to this.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, because it's not about justice. Mm-hmm. It is about winning and losing. Now, if a district attorney knows you're innocent, mm-hmm. but the police are saying, look, this is this, the district attorney has to go with the police and say, wait a minute, okay, so now we got to find out how to get this guy in jail. And it's been proven that the system is breaking down. It's been proven. Mm-hmm. My little cousin, Gilbert, he went to prison when he was 17, and right now he just got out last year. He's 55 years old.
Jeez.
Oh. So, it's kind of like, okay, if it wasn't for a program called Second Chance, this kid would have no, I think about it, 17, 55, you're still a kid. And I realized when I picked him up, they were so angry that he got out, I couldn't pick him up at the prison. I actually picked him up on the highway. Do you understand? They sent a van because they didn't want me on that property. Wow. Because a celebrity cameras follow us. So they brought him in a van out to the highway, and me and Mario, my assistant, picked him up there.
Let me show you a little clip from this documentary. Take a look at this. Watch.
We're going to follow the stories of two Americans. Bruce Lisker, an innocent man convicted of murder, and Reggie Cole, another innocent man who endured an even more horrific nightmare.
You're going to get perspectives from investigative journalists, analysts, academics, prison staff, lawyers, cops, inmates.
So in the unfortunate case that this may happen to you, this is the Survivor's Guide to Prison.
All right, the obvious intensity there. We know what's wrong.
Yeah.
What should be changed?
Well, first of all, we got to get the... got to get the decisions back into a judge's hands. It's because, again, it's like the district attorney has a job to do, and that's put people in jail. I know we talk about justice. That's all crap, really. It's like district attorneys aren't paid to set people free.
Right.
And
But you're going to have some people watching this right now saying, hey, wait a minute, district attorneys are trying to do their level best to, you know,
okay, to take people who've broken the law and put them in jail.
Absolutely, absolutely. But the problem is that if I have a case, whatever it is, and I can't afford an attorney, I can't afford legal representation, all he has to say is, look, you'll do these 10 years or plead guilty to 5. And if I had an attorney, I wouldn't have to plead guilty to anything. But because I can't afford an attorney, when you look at the prison population,
it's disproportionately poor.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And people of color. It's that simple.
What do you hope this documentary accomplishes?
I hope this documentary kind of lets people see that, wait a minute, man, what can we do about our system? What can we do about guns? What can we do about people being innocently sent to jail? I mean, think about it. There's 40, even if it was just only 40,000 people that are innocently in jail right now.
And when people that are in jail and didn't commit these crimes, do they have any way to still fight it once they're in there? Can they
talk to these people right now? They were found innocent and still spent about 8 more years in jail waiting to get out. There's no hurry to let you out of prison.
We tell you this, the Survivor's Guide to Prison hits select theaters this Friday, available on demand, digital HD. We'll bring Danny back on a lighter time to talk about the expanding empire of the tacos, donuts, the ice cream on the way, all that stuff. But Danny, we're glad you're here today to talk about
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.